Okay, 12 students, welcome to another accounting video. In this video, we will be doing VAT. It's a theory video on value added tax. So VAT is the tax charged on goods and services supplied and is charged at the current rate, standard rate, of 15%. It was 14% before, but it was changed, became 15%. By the minister. And VAT is an important part of the income generated by the government to cover government expenditures. You know that VAT is tax, and tax is used to cover government expenditures such as social grants, building infrastructure, etc. So now who has to register as a VAT vendor? A person that supplies goods or services can register as a vendor, meaning a trader, someone who owns a business. All businesses with a turnover of more than, turnover is also known as sales, guys. So all businesses with a turnover of more than 1 million must register as VAT vendors. This is compulsory registration. So there are two types of registration, compulsory and voluntary registration. Those businesses with a turnover of less than 1 million, they can register to be VAT vendors if they want to. So a VAT, meaning if you are a VAT vendor, you are collecting VAT on behalf of SARS, guys. You're collecting VAT on behalf of SARS. So whenever a customer comes and buys goods for you, they'll pay VAT, and then you'll take the VAT and take it to SARS, right? Right, that's what it means. But if you did not register as a VAT vendor, when you buy where you buy your goods or services, where you buy your goods or services, the supplier supplies you with your goods or services that you will be offering to other people, it means that you'll pay that supplier the VAT, and you won't get to recover the VAT because you do not collect the VAT from the customers that you sell your goods and services to. Right, that's what it means. The benefits of registering as a VAT vendor: the business is able to claim back the amount of VAT paid on goods and services bought. You see, just explains what I've just said to you right now. Now let's look at the items for which VAT is not charged. We have zero rated items. VAT is charged at 0% on these items, right? But this can be changed by the government at any time. Examples are fresh food, vegetables, brown bread, milk, maize, rice, lentils, and cooking oil. If you can see, these are actually the like basic foods. These are foods that, you know, people who are not so privileged or people who are from the low class or who are poor, these are the type of foods they afford. So the government has made an incentive to them to make these foods to be charged at 0% VAT. And then we have VAT exempt items. These items, you just cannot charge VAT on them, such as school fees, you know, interest rates, export services, educational services, school fees, childcare services. You just cannot charge VAT on these things. Like, they are exempt from VAT. No VAT is charged on them, you know. Another example could be salaries. VAT, so let's look at the two types of VAT. We have what we call VAT input and VAT output, and this in turn will help us to draw up the VAT control account, right? So it can help us to draw the VAT control account. So VAT input is the VAT paid by a business on the purchases of goods and services, which can be claimed back from SARS. Right, so this it means that when a business buys goods from a supplier, when business buys goods, it pays what? VAT input. So therefore, this is a what? This is an outflow, right? It's an outflow of cash because you money is going out, you're paying it to the supplier. VAT output is VAT collected by the business on the sale of all goods and services, which needs to be paid over to SARS, right? So this one can be claimed because we as the business, we're not the last ones to use the product. Generally, the idea behind VAT is that the person who gets to use the product last, like last person to use the product, is the one who's supposed to pay the VAT. So the VAT input, because we buy this goods and services to sell them, We buy the goods and services to sell them to someone else. We won't be the last one to use them, so you don't have to pay VAT input. Hence, it's an outflow. Actually, not that we don't have to pay it, but we can claim it back from SARS after we paid it. And how do we claim that VAT? We look at the difference between what we collect from the customers and what we pay, because this one is an inflow, right? We pay VAT to our suppliers, and we also collect VAT from our customers. So it means if the total amount of VAT that we collected from customers is 500, and the total amount of VAT we paid is 400, so it means we paid more than what we received. Therefore, in this case, we owe SARS, guys. We owe SARS because we must just not benefit or become disadvantaged. We must remain neutral. So it means the difference, which is 100 rand, is what we owe SARS, guys. So this concept is explained through the VAT control account. The VAT control account, you can see it such as just like a ledger account, where on your debit side is all the outflows of VAT, meaning this is where you'll have your VAT input. And then on the credit side is where you'll have your VAT output. As long as you are receiving VAT from customers, it's an outflow. As long as you are paying VAT, it's an inflow. So for example, it doesn't only apply to that. Let's say, for example, you had bought goods from a supplier, but now you are retaining them. So initially you bought the goods. Initially you bought, and what happens when you buy the goods? You pay VAT input, right? Meaning you're going to take the amount to the debit side of the VAT control account. And then when you return the goods, you do the opposite. You are no longer paying the VAT because you are retaining the goods, meaning the amount that you had paid, you are reversing it back. It's going back to you. Therefore, you have to, it's a VAT output because it's no longer an outflow, it's an inflow. You see? So when you return the goods, you do the opposite. This applies to many, many other things as well. Even when customers, they return goods to us, because initially they had paid VAT, it was VAT output. But now, since we are giving them the money that they paid back, it now becomes VAT input. It applies to a lot of scenarios, guys. You just need to check what was the initial action that was taken before, and then you just reverse that initial action. Even for bad debts, you know, for bad debts, initially what had happened, we had sold to the customers on credit, right? Initial. But now, since they did not pay us, we are reversing the debt. We are canceling the debt. Since they had paid the VAT, when you canceling the debt, the since they paid the VAT, when you canceling the debt, we do the opposite. It now becomes VAT output. It becomes VAT input. It's an inflow to the business because they had paid. It's an inflow. It's an inflow to the business. Oh, so that's just how that it is, guys. That's just how that it is. So please don't get confused by the inflow and outflow. Since the customers are paying that output to us, they are paying that output to us. It's credited. Why is it credited? It is because we owe SARS that money, because the customers paid the money to us. We owe SARS that money. That's why it's an outflow VAT. We look at from the perspective of us. It's not that we receive the money for us. We are receiving the money for SARS, right? That's why it's called outflow. Don't get confused by that. I hope this video will help you guys, and I'll do an example later on based on the VAT control account. Thank you very much.